So not the last meal at all.
The penultimate, penultimate.
Right? Penultimate, penultimate meal. I reckon Anthony's clocked it. Look at that.
I was just checking. It's okay.
And Old Faithful is the background. Last meal before the hike. Ooh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Up bright and early for day one of the hike. Just getting some breakfast. Pass an Old Faithful. Breakfast up here. Man, what do we got? 11 miles today? 10 miles today?
11, I believe.
11 with a side trip to the Lone Star Geyser.
Geyser.
Four geysers travel to the Lone Star Geyser. And the Shoshone Lake Pass. So, see how we go. Not a bad way to start our hike.
Just exploding.
Off with a bang.
What is that?
So we passed the Lone Star Geyser, right?
Yes, we passed the Lone Star Geyser.
And we've done, what, 6 miles, 7 miles today? Blake just loves being on camera. 7.2. With his hat. What was that?
7.2 miles.
7.2. How long we got to go?
About 3.5.
3.5 to Shoshone Lake. There's some geysers we want to check out.
Some geysers.
Some geysers checking out some geysers. Don't fall in. Shoshone Lake. Beautiful. Nice spot for lunch. Holy shit! Well, it's nice and warm. The water's so clear as well. Well, perimeter has been breached. Whoa, this is deep over here. Oh shit. Lovely. Okay. We have set up camp next to a creek. We had some tea and then we went down to Shoshone Lake to watch the sunset, even though the sun set on the west side, which it usually does. We had beans last night. Safe to say the gassy geysers or geysers are quite gassy tonight. But yeah, if you can hear that, that is the stream just about 10 meters to my right. That is going to make for a very, very peaceful sleep. We are up early tomorrow to watch the sun rise over Shoshone Lake. And then we've got some bush bashing to do all the way up the drainage, climbing a hill. I think we've got like 600 meters elevation tomorrow and about 5 or 6 miles, so pretty easy. But that is the end of day one. Good night.
I'm about to lose my toes. On the fucking warmest day of the trip.
Warmest night of the trip.
It freezes my balls off.
We're a couple of frozen biscuits. We are two dehydrated meals right now. Freeze-dried meals. But check that out. Frozen last sport eaters. Wow.
Fucking hell.
I've never seen that before. Oh, fuck. Good morning. Look at my shoes. Look at these.
You're fucking frozen. You guys are fucked. Yeah.
Yeah, we are. We're going to be hiking in Crocs today. Fuck. Jesus. Tell you what, not a bad way to wake up. I'm not in any rush, so I'm going to hang here and get my blood temperature back above freezing. Bye, camp.
Day two
commences. Crocs are on. Day two. 5 minutes into the trail, feet are already soaking wet. Auspicious signs. Oh, God. You made it.
I'm a bear.
So we've just cut through all that. There's no trail. Fun times. We're still no trail. I think the delirium's starting to set in. What do you reckon?
I'm getting a little renaissance.
A little bit loopy?
Yeah. You gotta fucking pick everybody's spirits up.
That's it. Onwards. Trees as far as the eye could see.
The old ocean.
An ocean of trees.
High fucking five.
Fuck okay, yeah. Dude.
Let's go.
Well done, good job. Good job. Fuck yeah.
Woo. That was fucking brutal.
There's the bet ball. And this is our campsite. Alright, should we look around before?
4 hours and 13 minutes.
This is how we do water in the bush. Fill this sack up, attach a filter to it, and then it just dribbles out. Pure Yellowstone water, aka life water. Day three.
Oh God, it's cold.
Good morning. Good cold morning. I think I got away with murder with my sleeping situation. Managed to pop a hole in my sleeping pad. Tried to patch it up and probably patched it up about 95% of the way. So I would inflate it and then it would deflate over the course of 2 hours while I was sleeping. And I'd end up on the floor, and the floor is extremely cold. So it was a cold, cold sleep. I'm going to patch it up again today and hopefully it works a little better. Got up early. Used up the rest of our gas canister. It's not even halfway through the trip. We've already used up half of our gas. So we might need to conserve the gas on the way through the next few campsites. Although we've got fires coming up, so we're very, very excited about that. Campfires, that is, not bushfires. Phil's doing well, recovering from his bout of altitude sickness or overexertion or whatever he had. And we've got, what do we got today?
8 mile hike.
8 miles.
Mr. Bubbles. 4 to camp.
4 to Mr. Bubbles, which should be fun. Hopefully the sun, although the day is looking quite nice. If the sun would just hurry the hell up and get on us because it's so cold. Mr. Bubbles is a thermal hot spring that we're allowed to swim in. You're not allowed to swim in things that are just coming from the ground, but this is a cold pool that's fed by two separate thermal pools. So it's like kind of boiling water being fed into a cold pool. So you're allowed to swim in that. So we're gonna do that today. Hopefully it's not too cold. So 4 hours to there, and then have lunch, and then 4 hours to camp. And, oh, is there no campfire tonight? Is there a campfire tonight?
Yeah.
Yes.
Campfire tonight.
Thank fuck.
Thank
fuck. Day three.
Day three.
Commencement.
Day three. Into the canyon.
Into the canyon. Gassy geezers. On the way to Mr. Bubbles.
Into the water.
Into the wild and into the wilder.
Morning, boss.
So this is 9D1, that way, we've come from that away, from his mug, and we're going to go on an unmarked trail that away for 0.3-ish, 0.4 miles till we hit Mr. Bubble. Allegedly. So here we go. We are at Mr. Bubbles. There's a cold stream here. There's a hot stream there. And then there's some bubbles that come up right there. The cold mixed with the hot provides a nice natural hot spring. Oh, it's just beautiful. We've just marched into Beckler Canyon. In Crocs. There's the Beckler River. Some really interesting rock features up there. Lots of color around. We're about an hour, maybe two from camp. Everyone's a bit sore, a bit tired, but we just had a lovely dip in the... Oh! Jeez, going downhill, this probably isn't advisable. Had a lovely dip in Mr. Bubbles, which is actually surprisingly hot. It's hotter than any spa I've been in. Which kind of tenderized my blisters, unfortunately. So now... walking with a bit of pain, but there's a campfire waiting for us at this campsite, which I am looking forward to. Number one, because we're all extremely cold, or we have been over the last few days. Number two, I've got a lot of wet shit that I need to dry. Might end up sleeping next to the campfire. Can barely talk. Campfire. Yeah, I think we've all been running a bit thin with food. Eating possibly a little less than we should. Even though we are eating a fair bit.
But yeah, having fun. Spirits haven't really dampened that much. You'd think if they were going to dampen, they'd probably dampen on day two when we did our off-trail bit, which was really fun, actually. Anyway, thought I'd do a little update, a little vlog. Coming into the end of day three, about to get into camp. I'll see you there. This is the Beckler River.
And we
must cross. And now I put the phone away. Wait, not just yet. I want to see if he falls in. Oh, it's not that deep. Oh. You made it. Yay, Blake. Victory dance. Yeah, Phil. Go, Phil. Bath water or what?
Mountain cold. Oh, fuck.
Mr. Bubbles would be good right about now, eh? Hell yeah, we get a fire tonight.
Oh, thank God.
Fire tonight.
Feet.
Yeah. After that river crossing. Fire. Day four. Jake's cold. Phil's cold.
It's wet.
It's wet. It's raining. We've got about 9, 10, 11 miles.
About
10?
10 miles, yeah.
10 miles. The first, how many to Dananda?
8.5.
Okay, so we're going 8.5 miles, and then we get to a hot spring. It's hard to be excited about that right now, but on the inside, I'm silently excited.
On the inside.
On the inside. On the outside, I'm wet. I really hope this doesn't... I don't know if you can see the rain, but it's everywhere.
It just means bigger river crossing later today.
This keeps getting better. Day four.
Not impressed. It's fucking cold. It's raining.
8 miles. To the turn off to, oh, apparently we're leaving. We better leave.
G2G.
We're going over there. Whoa. These are the Iris Falls. Crazy. Now I gotta put my phone away because it's still raining really. She's a soft oat. Spirits a little bit lower than usual. Hands frozen. But it's snowing.
We went through a snowstorm.
Snowstorm, a hailstorm.
We're now completely drenched.
Completely drenched, but we all seem to have...
We have one sleeping bag.
Each?
No, sorry, one sleeping mat.
One sleeping mat, two sleeping bags in my tent.
And 2 fucking days from
Milk Hut. 2 days hike to the car. And we almost all froze to death just before.
There was fucking snow. You look on the mountains. There was literally
snow everywhere. Could not believe that.
Day 5. Update. All is not well. All is not well. Update complete. Now I better give a proper update. It's my extremely wet tent that Blake and I shared last night. We didn't exactly have to spoon, but we were pretty close. We top and tailed and our butts warmed each other. Such is life in the outdoors. That necessitates body warmth sharing at sub-zero temperatures and rain, hail, and snow when one is not prepared for such things. Such as Blake and I. We did something stupid. We took our, well, we ate dinner in our tent, cooked in our tent using our gas burner. I mean, it kept us warm. And we were genuinely kind of fearing for our lives there, for our body temperatures. So that was something. And then neither of us could be bothered getting out of the tent because it was raining. Sub-zero temperatures. We only had one set of warm clothes left. So we slept with our bear bags. Which is our food and stuff, which you're not meant to do. Couple of options today. I think we're going to head. We're going to pack up all our stuff, which is a daunting task because that bag, I just left it out in the rain. So it's completely drenched. I can literally count the number of dry things is in this bag. And this. And this. And some thermals underneath. And this. Those are the number of dry things I have. Everything else I brought is wet. But yeah. Spirits are definitely lower than they were. Unfortunately, the sky ain't blue. The sun does not look like it's coming. Which means we might maybe end up going back to the car today, which is a long journey. But also, we might not. We might just camp and do it in our warm clothes. Not sure which way we're going to go yet, but for the time being, we're going to pack up. And we're going to roll on out and make a decision depending on circumstances. See you then. All right. Just changed into wet clothes. Had a bit to eat. Blake's got his nutties on. Off you go, Blake.
Nutties.
Lead the way, mate. Gotta cross this river.
Look at that tight ass.
Dead ass.
Zoom in.
It's working. What the fuck?
Twerking.
DJ in Australia.
The sun feels amazing. Old mate's still in his fucking jocks. And we have crossed the ford. Well done, team. Another fun adventure. For the gassy geezers. Crocs are on. Poles are out. Photos being taken. Looks like they found a way that's less deep than this way. So let's do that. This is our last campsite for the trip.
Going to catch the bear.
Blake throws a bear hang. Take one.
Go, mate.
Blake throws a bear hang. Take two.
That was
kids, or just fucking them?
Don't have all day. Come on, mate.
Yeah. Take two.
Hey!
Success!
Success! Good job. I really hope it doesn't start raining again. This is the result of our attempt at laundry. Ah, yes. Well, it's no longer wet. That is a plus. I guess it can stay there and continue to dry out. Cool. Day 6. Coffee time. We're trying to get a fire started. Relatively unsuccessfully. Well, Anthony's getting a fire started. We're having coffees. Blake's shivering his balls off over there. Our laundry's all turned into frozen ice blocks. And spirits are high.
Because we're getting the fuck out.
Because we're getting the fuck out of here today. I still have a, what is it, 7 miles and 1,000 feet incline today?
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah.
So maybe 3 or 4 hours, depending on how we go. And then back to the car, crack a beer, try and tackle this grassy lake road issue that will no doubt crop up when we get there. And then onto the lodge to feast and to get fucked up. Sounds like a plan. Day 6. This is a hack. The tent is steaming. All our frozen clothes are now drying.
And the campsite doesn't get sun.
Take the campsite to the sun. Hell yeah. Hiking through snow. In a shirt. Last day. Last few miles. Hell yeah. Well, that was a pretty difficult last climb. It was like 300 meters. 300 feet rather. Had to climb all the way down from that valley, all the way up. In my car. Well, let's see. Hopefully it hasn't been broken into. The others, I've left them a little bit behind because I wanted to come pack up the car. I know everyone's eager to go, so try and rearrange the car before 4 filthy bodies enter it, enter my bedroom. It's essentially my bedroom. At least for the next 3 months. Bike's still there. Car's still there. Yes! 6 days. Probably something like 65 miles or even more. And I've made it. Back to my little press. Ah. Oh. Worth it.
Just finished my hike. Just dropped off Phil. Now I'm going back to pick up the other two. This road is treacherous. Beautiful scenery though. Beautiful. Onwards. Guess who got picked up in the back of a pickup truck?
She tried the last one on. she just honors a hall, thinking nothing.
So this is the view from Flag Ranch. Currently about 4 o'clock or something. We just finished our hike.
Get on the Dan Andrews.
Get on the beers, the Grand Tetons. I think we've got a bunch of different things. We've got some Jameson going on over there. We've got some Snake River Pale Ales. There's a couple of other things in there. We've got some nibbles. And this is our little abode. Looks like me and Blake are bunking yet again.